Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to count the number of objects created of a class in Java. So let's get started. So currently I'm having here the sample class as well as its function. So I'll be creating another class and I'll be showing you how to count the number of objects. So I'll just go to the top above the class, default class. So it's going to be class. I will name the class as test, open curly bracket. So for this we'll be using the constructor of this particular class test. So for having a constructor, it's going to be public and just the class name, okay? Class name and the constructor name is going to be the same. Yeah. So this is going to be our constructor. So for this, to find the count of the object, we will be needing a counting variable. And this counting variable should be a global variable or a static variable. In Java, we don't have the concept of global variable like initializing at the top of the program like how you do in C or C++. But the exact same thing is done by using a static variable. So let me just create that. So within the class, it's going to be static int count. And we will initialize the count as 0. Like exactly the same thing that we do whenever if we have sum or count, we initialize to 0 and we find the value later. And within the constructor, we will be having count plus plus. So why we are having count plus plus within the constructor is because every time when an object is created, this constructor gets called. It gets initialized, okay? So once we are creating an object, first object, the count value gets incremented by 1. And when we are creating a second object, count gets incremented by 2, so on. So this is basically like a function call, but we are doing the function call with the help of an object on constructor, the properties of a class. I hope that made sense. So now let me just come inside my default class. This is a class that I've created and this is a default class. I'll just now create some objects of my class test. So for creating an object, it's going to be the class name. And our object name, let me name it as t1 equal to new test. So once this object is created, it will call the constructor. And for each time, like we are adding another object, this particular constructor will be getting called and the count value will be getting incremented. I hope that made sense. So I will just copy the exact same thing. I will paste it 4 times and I will just name it as t2 and t3 and t4. So now we need to display the output, okay? We need to get the count, we need to print the count. So that's how we will be able to display the user how many objects have been created. So for that at the end, it's going to be system.out.print. And another advantage what we have with static variable is that this particular static variable can be directly accessed by that particular class name itself. We don't even have to initialize an instance or an object of this test. We can directly access the static variable outside this particular class by just having the class name test itself. Okay, we don't need any help of the object. So as I told you, class name is test dot and we can just directly access the variable. No errors. Okay, I'm just accessing that particular variable data member of this class test directly by using the class name itself because I have had the static keyword over here. So now we need to get the output as 4. So I'm saving it and I am compiling it and I am running it now. So here you can see I've got the output as 4. So this is working now perfectly fine. And this is how you find the count of the number of objects of a class in Java. So I hope you would have found this video useful. I've also done many other tutorials in Java, C, C++, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL. So do check other videos of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.